Okay, here we are for game two on the play. This hand looks great. Very aggressive. We can play turn two Domri or voice, depending on what the situation calls for. Looks like our opponent's probably a mono green aggressive deck. Although I suppose green white sometimes plays experiment one as well. Ooh, but he does not look like he has a very good draw. Or we would probably see that experiment evolving. Okay, I guess that's not the worst for him. So I think we'll just go ahead and play Domri this turn. He could kill it, but he'd have to use an awful lot of his resources to do so. Fortunately, we whiffed. And if he doesn't kill it, if we can like play voice and fight it with something, that would just be great. I'd love to have a voice token in play by the time we're casting Scion of Itugazi, basically. Yeah, the only way this goes like super badly for us is if he plays like Burning Tree Emissary into something insane. But that doesn't look like the case. He's not even attacking with Elvish Mystic. Ah. He is killing our Domri. But that's fine. We traded Aspect of the Hydra for it, which is probably one of his better cards against us. So I still just want to play Voice here and then pass. If we can proliferate a Voice token, I can't really imagine the mono green deck has a lot of good answers to that. And then the next turn, Elspeth is just going to be completely unbeatable. Okay, so he gets to evolve. I don't really think he'll want to attack, though. He's going for it. We'll definitely trade. And a land, perfect. All right, so our voice will make 2 5/5 voice tokens and a bird and a 4/4. Yeah, that seems pretty fair. I guess we can go ahead and attack too. Might as well. This board feels pretty insurmountable for our opponent. Like, even if he had, I don't remember the name of the card, but the 3-mana 1/1 that gets +1/+1 for each green symbol he has, it'd still only be a 6/6, which is going to be smaller than these voice tokens as soon as we get an Elspeth into play. Yeah, I don't think the oodles of experiment ones are going to cut it here. Alright, let's just jam Elspeth and make some tokens. Then we'll have a couple of 8/8s. So the only thing I want to make sure of is that we don't die to something silly, like double aspect of Hydra. So I think we'll just attack with 1/8/8 this turn. Given that next turn we can play Porphyros and plus, which deals him 6. So he's basically dead next turn. We basically just have to make sure that we don't do something silly that causes us to lose. All right, I don't think Witch Stalker is exactly going to cut it on this board. Yeah, we can just actually kill him with triggers. Porphyros. Elvish Mystic. Take two. And plus Elspeth, take another 3. Or take another 6. Alright. There we go. So for sideboarding, I wonder about the anger plan, if it's good against him. Xenagos and Porphyros seem pretty bad to me. They're just very expensive and kind of clunky. Archangel, I think I'm going to try Archangel Anger. And Banishing Light's probably good. Domri's probably not great. So let's try this plan out. The Anger voice thing is kind of awkward. Yeah, maybe we won't try Anger. We'll try Domri as our way to leverage having big voice tokens, and maybe we'll try Nyx Fleece Ram. Alright, yeah, this looks okay. I think Nyx Fleece Ram might be good in just blocking an Experiment 1 or whatever.